भूपेंद्र सिंह जी, समय सबके लिए दो दो मिनट दिया गया है, ये मेरी बाध्यता है कि मैं दो मिनट के, चूंकि आप सब नेता हैं और वहां समय तय करते हैं, वही तब समय पर मुझे बात करना होती है, इसलिए किसी को नाराज होने की जरूरत नहीं है। प्लीज प्लीज भूपेंद्र सिंह जी।
Honorable Vice Chairman, sir, I have been thinking time and again that why the name is the School of Planning and Architect Bill. I think I draw the attention of the entire house, including the Honorable Minister Madam and the government. It should have been named as Knowledge, Planning and Architect, or University and something like that, not school. And I must thank at the outset the Society of Autonomous Society who started the first school in 1959. Five decades after that, the second and third Bhopal and Vijayawada came into. As a minister of in my state as urban development, 1999, when just going goodbye to the 20th century, I visioned for 2020, what will be the size of India's urban India. The way the rural people are rushing towards the cities, and sometimes we call planning means to me, planning, they can only make plan those who have vision. Without vision, there cannot be any planning. My state, my city of Bhubaneswar, the capital city, is known as the temple city of India. I can claim that it's the temple city of the world, where Jainism, Buddhism, everything has come up from there. And we are talking about 300 years back, 400 years back. Go back to BC. My architects, they made such an heritage, Konark Temple, 12th century. Konark Temple is one of the world monument recognized by UNESCO. And there are so many temples made by our architect. And unfortunately, the two schools, which has been mentioned by our previous speaker, it is unfortunate if it has not been. AICT approval is not there to the central government schools. Where are we then? It is really a question. It is a same for us. Rather, I will say, if the government institutions, central government institutions, will be neglected by AICT, and our students will not get degree, what after coming out from there, what will be their fate? What has been if it is a fact like that? So I would like to request the Honorable Minister, the sun rises from my state, that is Chandrabhaga near Konark. And I appeal you, madam, I have been seeing for last 6 months here, any proposal, anything is coming, the East and the Eastern India is not in the map. Why it is? What for it is? So that we have to bring we have to bring motion here for that. I would like to request you that at least the Central School of Planning should be there in Odisha also, and in Odisha. And sir, it has been mentioned here on page 411, the visitor, the president of India shall be the visitor of every school. The first citizen of this country, His Excellency, I would like to request if some other name can be put, again, if it cannot be visitors, some other name can be found out, then visitor. Then, sir, regarding the deemed to be university has been made, the Delhi School of Planning is after 20 years, it has become deemed to be university. Now, for the information of the house, deemed to be university means they are totally, they will make their own syllabus. They will make their own examinations. Their results will be framed by them. They can give any mark. They can give any degrees to their students. But rest Bhopal and similarly, Vijayawada students, they have to go through our channel. So, sir, there should be uniformity in the syllabus. There should be uniformity in the examination. There should be uniformity in the result also. That is what is lacking. Otherwise, this central government runs schools that children will not get degree properly and they will fail. And as you, I would not like to mention it here, but what we feel, our education has become more commercial than to lead to the place of learning, the place of information. It is rather going towards commercialization. That we have to check. And I congratulate the government. I thank the minister bringing such a bill which should have been brought long, long back, because after 5 decades, we have to wait 5 decades. If there is no planning, we call it today in natural calamities. This house is concerned for natural calamities in Uttarakhand, in Hudhud, in Andhra and Odisha and Srinagar. Sir, last 1 minute.
Thank you.
Last word, sir, last 1 minute. Sir, man-made flood, we call it in cities. Why it has come? Because 500 smart cities, has we ever have going for planning? The small township which has been looked after by urban bodies, has there any planning? The real way of, the natural way of water sources to the town, we are closing those natural ways. That is that cause flood inside the cities, inside the urban areas. So we call it as man-made natural calamities. We have to, so it is the answer is only by proper planning, proper architect, and to that, sir, the 21st century today demands that it should include a subject like Vastu into it. Without Vastu, there cannot be any architecture building, any future. I would like to request the Honorable Minister to add the word Vastu also in this subject. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. With this, my party and I support this bill.
Thank you.